Where to begin? It all seems like so long ago, and had we known at the time, we never would have tried to play God. My associates and I had a simple dream, to rid man of the cumbersome nature of labor, and to dedicate our intellect and our skills to more worthwhile pursuits. We were wrong, so very wrong.
Reading?
Yes.
A letter. To the Ian McVicar & Co., Southampton, England. We undertake no guarantee for goods damaged in transit. As soon as the consignment was taken on board, we drew your captain's attention to the fact that the vessel was not suitable for the transport of robots, and we are therefore not responsible for spoiled freight. We beg to remain the Rawson's Universal Robots. Yours truly. Ready?
Yes.
Another letter. To the E.B. Hudson Agency, New York, USA. We beg to acknowledge receipt of order for 5,000 robots. As you are sending your own vessel, please dispatch as cargo equal quantities of soft and hard coal. The same to be credited as a part payment for the amount due to us. We beg to remain the Rawson's Universal Robots. Yours truly. Ready?
Yes.
Another letter. To Frederick's Works, Hamburg, Germany. We beg to acknowledge receipt of order for 15,000 robots. Hello? Yes. This is the central office. Yeah. I'll send them an email. Good. Where was I?
We beg to acknowledge receipt of order for 15,000 robots.
15,000 robots. 15,000 robots. Well?
There is a lady, sir, asking to see you.
A lady? Who is she?
I did not know, sir. She brings this card and watches.
Ah, President of Glory. Send her in.
Please, step this way.
How do you do?
And how do you do?
You're Mr. Donovan, the general manager.
I am.
I have come.
With President Glory's card. That is quite sufficient.
President Glory is my father. I am Helena Glory.
Oh, my dear Miss Glory. It is such a great honor for us to welcome the great president's daughter.
Then you can't show me the door.
Please, take a seat. Sullivan, you may go. So, how can we be of service to you, Miss Glory?
Well, I have come
to get a look at the famous works where people are manufactured. Of course, there is no objection.
But I thought it was forbidden.
To enter the factory? Yes. Everybody comes here with someone's visiting card, Miss Glory.
And you show them?
Only certain things. The manufacture of artificial people is a secret.
If only you knew how enormously that
interests me. Europe is talking about nothing else.
Why don't you let me finish speaking?
I beg your pardon. Did you want to say something different?
I only wanted to ask
whether we can make a special exception in your case and show you our factory. Why, certainly, Miss Glory.
How did you know I wanted to say that?
They all do. But we shall consider it a special honor to show you more than we do the rest.
Thank you.
But you must agree not to divulge the...
Oh, of course not. My word of honor.
Thank you. Won't you remove your hat?
Of course. You want to see if I'm a spy or not. I beg your pardon.
What is it?
Would you mind releasing my hand?
I beg your pardon.
How cautious you have to be here, don't you?
Oh, yes. Of course. I see it.
What is it? What's the matter?
I am remarkably pleased. Did you have a pleasant flight?
Yes.
No difficulty?
Why?
No. It's just that you're so young.
May we go straight into the factory?
Yes. 22, I think.
22 what?
Years.
21. Why do you need to know?
Well, it's just that, you will make it a long stay, won't you, Miss Glory?
Oh, well, now that depends on how much of a factory you have to show me.
Oh, to hell with the factory, Miss Glory. No, no, no. You shall see everything. Indeed you shall. But first, would you like to hear the story of the invention?
Yes, please.
Thank you, Marius. It was year 2020. And then, old Rossum, the great microbiologist, who was then quite a young scientist, took himself to this distant island for the purposes of studying the ocean fauna. But there, he attempted biochemical synthesis to imitate the living matter known as protoplasm, until he suddenly discovered a new substance which behaved exactly like living matter, but was made up of a different chemical substance. That was the year 2032, exactly 540 years after the European discovery of America.
You know that off by heart.
Yes. I prepared the speech for the tour guides personally. Shall I go on?
Yes, please.
Well, Rossum then wrote the following on his chemical specimens. Life has found but one method of organizing living matter. There is, however, another method, more flexible, simple, and rapid, that had not yet occurred to nature at all. And that second method by which life could be developed was discovered by me here today. Now imagine him, Miss Laurie, sitting over some colloidal mess that a dog wouldn't look at, looking into a test tube and envisioning how the tree of life would grow from it, how all life would proceed from it, beginning with some sort of beetle and ending with a man. A man of different substance to us, Miss Laurie. That was a tremendous moment.
Well?
Well, then was how to get life out of the test tube to hasten development, form organs, bones, and so on, and create such substances as catalysts, enzymes, and so forth. In short, he... Do you understand?
Not very much, I'm afraid.
Never mind. For you see, with the help of his tinctures, he could have produced anything that he wanted. He could have created a Medusa with the brain of a Socrates, or a worm 50 yards long. But, being without a grain of humor, he took it in upon himself to create a vertebrate, or perhaps a man. This artificial living matter of his had a raging thirst for life. He didn't mind being sewn or mixed together, and that is how he set about it.
About what?
About playing God. First, he tried making an artificial dog. That took him several years and resulted in some sort of stunted calf, which died within a few days. And then, old Rossum began on his manufacture of man.
And I must divulge this to nobody.
Nobody in the world, Miss Laura.
Oh, well, isn't it a pity, then, that exactly the same story is to be found in all of the schoolbooks of both Europe and America?
Yes, but do you know what isn't in the schoolbooks? That old Rossum was mad. Seriously, Miss Laura, you must keep this to yourself. The old crank actually wanted to make people.
You do make people?
Approximately, Miss Glory. But old Rossum, he meant it literally. He wanted to become some sort of scientific substitute for God. He was a fearful materialist, and that is why he did it all. His sole purpose was nothing more nor less than to prove that God was no longer necessary. Do you know anything about anatomy?
Very little.
No, never mind. So, then old Rossum began to manufacture everything as in the human body. I was showing the museum the bungling attempt it took him 10 years to produce. It would have to have been a man, but it lived for 3 days only. And then, up came the young person, the engineer. Oh, he was a wonderful fellow, Miss Glory. And when he saw what a mess of it the old man was making, he said, "It is absurd to spend 10 years making a man. If you cannot make him quicker than nature, then you might as well shut up shop." And then he set about learning anatomy for himself.
There's nothing about that in the schoolbooks.
Oh, no. The schoolbooks are full of paid advertisements and rubbish like that. But the schoolbooks say of the united efforts, the two great Rossums is a complete fairy tale. He used to have the most dreadful of rows. The old atheist hadn't the slightest notion of industrial matters. And the end of it was that the old Rossum was shut up in some laboratory or another and let him fritter his time away with the monstrosities. The old man, he cursed the young Rossum. And before he died, managed to botch up two physiological horrors. And then one day, they found him dead in the laboratory. And that is his whole story.
But then what about the young man?
Well, if anyone had looked into human anatomy, they will see at once that man is too complicated, and that a good engineer could make him more simply. So young Rossum began an overhaul of anatomy. He began to see what could be left out or simplified. In short, he... But this isn't boring you, Miss Clark.
Oh, not at all. You're... It's... Very interesting.
So, the young Rossum said to himself, "Man is something that feels good, likes to play the piano, enjoys going for a walk, and in fact, likes to do a whole lot of other things that are rather unnecessary."
Oh.
It is is unnecessary one he wants, let us to say, to sew or craft. Do you play the piano?
Yes.
And that is good. But a machine must not play the piano. It must not feel happy. A motor must not have ornaments or tassels. And to manufacture artificial people is the same as to manufacture motors. The process must be of the simplest, and the product must be of the best from the practical point of view. Tell me, Miss Glory, what sort of worker do you think is best from the most practical point of view?
What?
What sort of worker do you think is best from the most practical point of view?
Well, perhaps the one who is most honest and hardworking.
Oh, no. I'm afraid not. It is the one that is the cheapest, the one whose requirements are the smallest. Rossum invented a worker with the minimum amount of requirements. He had to simplify it. He rejected everything that did not contribute directly to the process of work. Everything that makes man more complicated. In fact, he rejected man, and he made the robot. My dear Miss Glory, the robots are not people. Mechanically, they are more perfect than we are. They have an enormously developed intelligence. But they have no soul.
How do you know they have no soul?
Have you ever seen what a robot looks like on the inside?
Well, no.
It is very neat, very simple. Really a beautiful piece of work. The product of an engineer is technically at a higher pitch of perfection than the product of nature.
But man is supposed to be the product of God.
On the worst, God hadn't the least notion of modern engineering. Would you believe that the young Rossum then had his crack at playing God?
How do you mean?
He began to manufacture the super robots. Regular giants they were. He tried making them 12 feet tall, but you would not believe what a failure they were.
A failure?
Yes, for no reason at all. Their limbs just kept snapping off. Evidently, our planet is too small for giants. And now, we only make robots of a normal size, in a very high class human finish.
I saw the first robots back home. Our town council, they bought, engaged them for work.
Bought them, my dear Miss Glory? Robots are bought and sold.
These were employed as street sweepers. I used to watch them sweeping. They were so strange and quiet.
Rossum's Universal Robot Factory does not produce a uniform brand of robots. We have robots of finer and coarser grades. The best will live about 20 years.
And then they die.
Yes, they get used up. I'll show you the examples of our two extremes. Marius, bring in the examples of the manual labor robot. The following are relatively inexpensive and made in vast quantities. There you are. As powerful as a small tractor, guaranteed to have average intelligence. That will do, Marius.
They make it look so strange.
Did you see my new admin girl?
Well, I'm afraid I didn't notice her.
Oh. There you are, Sulla. Let Miss Glory see you.
Oh, well, how do you do? You must find it terribly dull in this out-of-the-way spot, don't you?
I do not know, Miss Glory.
Oh, where are you from?
The factory.
Oh, you were born here.
I was made here.
What?
Sulla is a robot. Best grade.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Sulla isn't angry. See the kind of skin we make, Miss Glory? You wouldn't believe she's made from a different material than us. Touch her face.
No.
Turn around, Sulla.
No, don't.
Speak to Miss Glory, Sulla.
Please, sit down. Did you have a pleasant flight?
Well, yes, thank you.
Don't go back on that little biplane, Miss Glory. The barometer is falling steadily. Wait for the Airbus. That is a strong, powerful airship.
What is its speed?
1,600 kilometers per hour. One of the latest vessels, Miss Glory.
Oh, well, thank you.
A crew of first-class flight attendants, Captain Harvey, eight jet engines.
That will do, Sulla. Show us your knowledge of French.
Oh, you know French.
I can write 47 languages. I can write dear sir, monsieur, Virginie.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Sulla isn't a robot. Sulla is a girl like me. Sulla, this is outrageous. Why take part in such a hoax?
I am a robot.
No, you're not telling the truth. I know they forced you to do this for an advertisement. Sulla, you are a girl like me, aren't you?
I'm sorry, Miss Glory, but Sulla is a robot.
It's a lie!
Excuse me? Well, then I must convince you. Marius, take Sulla into the dissecting room.
Where?
Into the dissecting room. When they've opened her up, you can go back there and have a look for yourself.
No!
Excuse me? You're the one that spoke of life.
You wouldn't have her killed.
You can't kill machines.
Oh, don't be afraid, Solar. I won't let you go. Tell me, my dear, are they always so cruel to you? You mustn't put up with it, Solar. You really mustn't.
I am a robot.
Oh, that makes no difference. Robots are just as good as we are. Solar, you wouldn't let yourself be cut to pieces.
Yes.
You're not afraid of death, then?
I cannot tell, Miss Glory.
Do you know what will happen to you in that room?
Yes, I shall cease to move.
But that's awful.
Marius, tell Miss Glory what you are.
I am Marius, the robot.
And would you take Solar into the dissecting room?
Yes.
What would happen to her in there?
She would cease to move. That would put her into the recycler.
Would you feel sorry for her?
I cannot tell.
That is death, Marius. Are you afraid of death?
No.
You see? The robots have no interest in life. They have no enjoyments. They are less than the grass we walk upon.
Stop it! Send them away!
Marius, Sulla, you may go.
This is outrageous what you're doing!
Why outrageous?
I don't know, but it is. Why do you call her Sulla?
Isn't it a nice name?
It's a man's name. Sulla was a Roman general.
We thought Marius and Sulla were lovers.
Marius and Sulla were generals who fought against each other in the year... Got him now.
Come here to the window.
What?
Come here. Ugh. Tell me what you see.
Bricklayers.
Robots. All of our workmen are robots. And down there?
Some sort of office.
Our accountant's office. And in it?
A lot of accountants.
Robots. All of our accountants are robots. And when I show you the factory... Noon. We have to blow the whistle so the robots know when to stop work. In 2 hours, I'll show you the mixer.
Mixer?
Yes. The place for beating up the pays. We mix the ingredients for 1,000 robots in one operation. And then there are the vats for the brains, the liver, and the organs, and so forth. And then there's the bone factory. And after that, I'll show you the spinner.
Spinner?
Yes. The place for weaving the veins and nerves and so on. Miles and miles of digestive tubes pass through it at a time.
Okay, can we talk about something else?
Perhaps it would be for the best. There's only a handful of us here among the 100,000 robots. And not one woman. We talk about the factory all day. Every day, as if we're under a curse, Miss Glory.
Sorry, I said you were lying.
Oh, come in. Begging your pardon, I hope we don't intrude. Don't be silly. This is August, Fabry, Gaul, and Hallemeyer. This is President Glory's daughter.
How do you do?
Busman!
How do you do?
Hello.
This is Busman, Miss Glory. This is President Glory's daughter.
Oh, by Jove, that's good. Should we notify the journalists about your arrival?
Oh, no. Please, don't.
Take a seat, Miss Glory.
Allow me.
Oh,
excuse me.
Oh.
What do you think about the fact that Miss Glory, I'm actually
taking this? Be quiet!
And let Miss Glory speak.
What am I to speak to them about?
Anything you like.
May I speak frankly?
Of course.
Tell me, doesn't it ever distress you the way you're treated?
By whom? May I ask?
Well, everybody.
Treated them?
How do you mean?
Well, don't you think you might be living a better life?
That depends on what you mean, Miss Glory.
I mean, it's perfectly outrageous. It's terrible. The whole world is talking about the way you're being treated. That's why I came here to see for myself. And it's 1,000 times worse than could have been imagined. How do you put up with it?
Put up what?
Good heavens, you're all living creatures just like us, the whole world. It's disgraceful you must live like this.
Good gracious, Miss Glory.
Well, I guess she's not far wrong. We do live like refugees.
Worse than refugees. May I call you brothers?
What up?
Brothers, I have not come here as the president's daughter. I have come here on the behalf of the Humanity League. Brothers, the Humanity League now has over 200,000 members. 200,000 people are on your side, and we offer you our help.
200,000? That's a tidy lot, Miss Glory. Not bad.
I'm always telling you guys, there's nothing like good old Europe. You see, they've not forgotten us. They're offering us help.
What help?
6D movie theater?
Perhaps there's no carpet theater restaurant.
More than that.
Just you.
Never mind about me. I will stay as long as is needed.
Oh, by Jove, that's good.
Don't worry, I'm going to get the best room ready for this door.
Just a moment.
It seems that Miss Glory has been of the opinion that she has been speaking with robots.
Of course.
I'm terribly sorry, Miss Glory.
But they are people, just like you and I.
You're not robots.
Not robots.
Robots indeed.
No, thanks.
Upon my honor, Miss Glory, we aren't robots.
Then why did you tell me that all of your staff are robots?
Well, the officials, yes. But not the managers. Allow me, Miss Glory. This is Fabry. Mr. Fabry. Head of the General Technical Department of Blossom's Universal Robots. This is Dr. Gall. Head of the Psychological and Experimental Department.
It is a pleasure.
Dr. Hallemeyer. Head of the Psychological Institute for the Training of Robots. This is Consul Bussman, our General Business Manager.
How do you do?
And Mr. Alvarez, head of our building department.
Just a building.
Forgive me, gentlemen, for I... Have I done something dreadful?
No, 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 Miss Glory. Please, take a seat.
I'm a stupid girl. Send me back by the next flight.
Not for anything in the world, Miss Glory. I mean, why would we send you away?
Well, because now you know I have come to disturb your robots for you.
Oh, my dear Miss Glory. We've had close upon 1,000 saviors and prophets here. Every new ship brings us some. Anarchists, Salvation Army, Jehovah's Witnesses. You'd be astounded at what number of idiots there are in the world.
And you let them speak to the robots.
So far we have, why not? The robots remember everything. But that is all. Really, it's quite remarkable. If it should please you, I can take it down to the warehouse. It holds about 300,000 of them.
347,000.
Good. And whilst you're there, you can say to them whatever you like. You can read the Bible, recite the multiplication table. You can even preach to them about human rights.
Oh, well, I'm sure if you were to show them a little love...
Oh, no, impossible, Miss Glory. You see, nothing is harder to like than a robot.
Well, then why make them?
Well,
why make them?
For work, Miss Glory. Just one robot can replace 2.5 workmen. The human machine, Miss Glory, was terribly imperfect. It had to be removed, sooner or later.
It was just too expensive.
Ah, it was not effective. It no longer answers the requirements of modern engineering. Nature just has no idea of keeping pace with modern labor. For example, from a technical point of view, the whole of childhood is a sheer absurdity. So much time lost, and then again...
No, no!
Pardon me, but kindly tell me what the real aim of your group, your Humanity League, is.
Our true purpose is to protect the robots and ensure good treatment for them.
Not a bad object either. A machine has to be treated properly, and upon my soul, I approve of that. You see, I don't like damaged articles. Please, Miss Glory, enroll us all as contributing or regular. What even foundation members of your league?
No, you've misunderstood me. What we really want is to liberate the robots.
Oh, tell me, how would you propose to do that?
Well, they're to be dealt with like human beings.
What's next? Suppose they're to vote, drink beer, all that's about.
Well, why shouldn't they drink beer?
Oh, perhaps they even to receive wages too.
Of course they are.
Oh, and tell me, what does they do with the wages? Shall they pray?
They would buy what they need, what pleases them.
Oh, that would be nice, Miss Glory. Only you see, nothing does please the robots. Good heavens, what would they buy? You see, you can feed them on pineapple, straw, whatever you like. It's all the same to them. There's no appetite at all, no interest in anything. Good heavens, no one's ever yet seen one smile.
Well then, why don't you make them happier?
That would not do, Miss Glory. They are only workmen.
But they're so intelligent.
Confoundedly so, yeah. But they're nothing else. You see, they lack any will of their own. No passion, no soul.
No love?
Love. No, rather not. Robots don't love. Not even themselves.
What about defiance?
Defiance? I don't know. Only rarely, from time to time.
How do you mean?
Occasionally, you see, they seem to go off their heads. Something like epilepsy, you know.
It's called Robert's Crumb. So suddenly stand still, sink down using the holding, gnash their teeth. And then we have to put them into the recycler. It's obviously a breakdown in the internal mechanism.
There's a flaw in the works that needs to be removed.
No, that's the soul.
Oh no, you really think that the soul first shows itself by a gnashing of teeth?
No, but it's a sign of a struggle. There's a revolt within. Oh, if only you can infuse them with it.
It will be remedied, Miss Glory. Dr. Gold is currently making some experiments.
Not in regard to that, Diamond. At present, I am making pain nerves.
Pain nerves?
Yes. You see, young Rossum designed the robots with too limited nervous system. We must introduce suffering.
Why would you want to cause pain?
For industrial reasons, Miss Glory. Say, a robot takes his hand, puts it in a machine, smashes his head. It's all the same to him because he doesn't feel it. Pain is the body's automatic defense against damage, after all.
Well, will they then be happier once they can feel pain?
On the contrary, Miss Glory. But they will be more perfect from a technical point of view.
Well, if you can create those, why don't you create a soul for them?
I'm sorry, Miss Glory, but that's not in our power.
That's not really in our interest.
That would increase the cost of production. Hang it all, my dear young lady. We turned them out at such a cheap rate. $150, each fully dressed. And 15 years ago, they cost $10,000. Why, 5 years ago, we used to buy the clothes for them. And now we have our own textile factory. And we export cloth 5 times cheaper than other factories. Would you mind telling me what you pay for a yard of cloth, Miss Glory?
I have no idea. I've forgotten.
Oh, good heavens. And you want to found a humanity league? It only costs a third now, Miss Glory. All prices today are a third of what they were. And they'll fall still lower, lower, lower. Like that.
I don't understand.
Ah, bless you, Miss Glory. It means that the cost of labor has fallen. A robot, food and all, costs us 0.75 cents per hour. It's mighty important, you know. All factories will go pop like chestnuts if they don't at once buy our robots to lower the cost of production.
And get rid of their workmen?
Of course. But in the meantime, we've dumped 500,000 of tropical robots on the Argentine Pampas to grow corn. Now, would you mind telling me what you pay for a pound of bread, Miss Corey?
No idea.
Well, I'll tell you. It now costs just 2 cents in good old Europe. 2 cents for a pound of bread, and the Humanity League knows nothing about it. You don't realize that even that's too expensive. In 5 years' time, I'll wager...
What?
Well, and everything won't cost a tenth of what it does now. In 5 years' time, we'll be up to our ears in corn, and everything else.
Well, that may be, but still, all the workers throughout the world will still be unemployed.
Yes, Albus, they will. And yes, Miss Glory, they will. But in 5 years' time, Rossum's Universal Robot Factory will produce so much corn, so much cloth, so much everything, the world will be practically without price. There will be no poverty. All work will be done by living machines. And man will be free to care of nothing but perfecting himself.
Will he?
Of course. It's bound to happen. And then the servitude of man to man and the enslavement of man to matter will cease. And yes, terrible things may happen at first, but that simply can't be avoided. No one will get bread at the cost of life and hatred. The robots will wash the feet of the beggar and prepare a meal for him in his home.
Don, what you say sounds too much like paradise. There's something good in service and something great in humility. There's a certain kind of virtue in toil and weariness.
Perhaps. But we cannot reckon with what is lost when we set out to transform the world. Man shall be free and supreme. He will have no other care, no other cause, no other labor other than to perfect himself. He will no longer be a symbol for production. He will be Lord of creation.
Amen.
So be it.
You have bewildered me. I should like to believe this.
You are younger than us, Miss Glory. You will live to see it.
Oh, true. Don't you leave Miss Glory out of lunch with us?
Yes, Diamond, ask for us.
Miss Glory, will you do us the honor?
When you know why I've come...
For the League of Humanity, Miss Glory.
In that case,
Okay!
But please excuse me for 5 minutes.
Oh, please excuse me too, Miss Glory.
I'll be right back.
We'll be back in exactly 5 minutes.
What have they all gone off for?
To cook, Miss Glory.
To cook what?
Lunch. The robots do all our cooking for us, and as they have no sense of taste, it's not altogether...
Oh.
Yes. Alamire is awfully good at grills, and Gold can make some kind of sauce, and... Busman knows all about onions.
What a feast! And what's the specialty of Mr. Your builder?
Eloquist.
Yes.
Nothing. He merely lays the table. And Fabry would get together a little fruit. Our cuisine is quite modest, Miss Laura.
I wanted to ask you something.
And I wanted to ask you something. 4 more minutes.
Well, why did you want to ask me?
Excuse me. You asked first.
Okay. Perhaps this is silly of me, but why manufacture female robots when
sex means nothing to them?
Yes.
There's a certain demand for it, you see. Saleswomen, stenographers, servants, people are used to it.
Okay. But are all of the robots, male, female, they're all mutually, completely without...
They are completely indifferent to each other, Miss Glory. There's not a single sign of affection between any one of them.
That's horrible.
How do you mean?
It's so unnatural. One doesn't know whether to be disgusted or to hate them or perhaps...
To pity them.
That's more like it. What did you want to ask?
I wanted to ask you, Miss Glory, whether you will marry me.
What?
Will you be my wife?
No! The idea!
If you won't marry me, I'm afraid you're going to have to marry one of the other 5.
Why should I?
Because they're all going to ask you in turn.
Oh, they wouldn't dare do such a thing.
I'm terribly sorry, Miss Glory. I'm afraid they've all fallen quite in love with you.
Oh, God, please don't let them. I will go away at once.
Miss Glory, you wouldn't be so cruel as to refuse us.
I can't marry all 6!
No, but one anyhow. And if you don't want me, I'd recommend Fabry.
I won't.
Dr. Gold?
I don't want any of you! Oh. You know, I think you would marry any woman who came here.
Plenty of them have come, Billy.
Young?
Yes.
Well, why didn't you marry one of them?
Because I did not lose my head. Not until today. As soon as you lifted your hat. 1 more minute, Elena.
Don't want you, I tell you.
1 more minute. And now you have to look me in the eye and say no, firmly. And I will leave you alone. Unless...
You're mad.
A man has to be a bit mad, Elena. It is the best thing about him.
You're...
Well...
I don't know.
Last chance, Elena. It is now or never. Come in. Are you finished with your job?
Yes.
So are we.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, my boy.
Uneventfully, Miss Elaine McGlory married Harry, and they began a life together. Although they never had any children of their own, their lives never lacked the luster one usually associates with childless couples, and instead, they enriched each other's lives. The robot's cramp, as Hamai liked to refer to it, was starting to worsen, and between Dr. Gall and himself, they sought to find a solution to this anomaly. Dr. Gall tended to spend hours either alone in his office or under the watchful eye of Helena. If I had suspected at the time, then maybe I could have done something about it. But no, I couldn't have.
She's still asleep? As long as she's asleep, she can't worry about it.
She knows nothing about it.
Certainly hope nothing happens today.
Oh, for goodness sakes, drop it all. Look, Harry, it's a fine cyclamen, isn't it? It's a new sort. My letters. Cyclamen Helena.
Still no sign of the ship. Things must be getting pretty bad.
Oh, be quiet. Suppose she hurt you.
I tell you what, the Ultimus has arrived just in time.
You really think that today?
I don't know!
How's these flowers, Pat?
See some new primroses, my new jasmine. They've discovered a wonderful way of developing some quickly. Splendid varieties, too. Next year, I'll be making marvelous ones.
What? Next year?
Yeah, I give a good deal to know what's happening at Harvard.
Quiet!
Emma!
She's awake! Out you go! Out you go! Out you go! Go, 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 go!
Oh, horrid mere pick of heathens! If I had my say,
Emma, would you come to my dress-up?
Oh, I'm coming. So, you're up at last. My gracious, what brutes.
Who?
If you want to turn around, then turn around, but I shan't fasten you up.
What are you going on about now?
These dreadful creatures, these heathens.
The robots.
Well, I wouldn't even call them by name.
What's happened?
Another one of them here has caught it. Started smashing up the statues, the pictures in the drawing room. Gnashed his teeth, foamed in the mouth. Quite mad, worse than an animal.
Well, which one caught it?
The one who... Well, he doesn't have a Christian name. The one who's in charge of the library.
Oh, God, Radius!
That's him. Oh, my goodness, I'm scared of them. The spider doesn't scare me as much as them.
Emma, I'm surprised you're not sorry for them.
Why, you're scared of them, too. You know you are. Why else would you bring me here?
I'm not scared of them, Emma. Really, I'm not. I'm only sorry for them.
Oh, you're scared of them. You can't help but being scared of them. Why, even the dog's scared of them. He won't take a scrap of meat out of their hands. He draws up his tail and he howls when he knows they're about.
The dog has no sense.
He's better than them. And he knows it. Oh, even the horse shies away when they meet them. They don't have any young, and a dog has pups. Everyone has children.
Would you finish fastening up my dress, please, Emma?
I say, it's against God's will to...
What is it that smells so nice?
Flowers.
What for?
Now you can turn around.
Oh, Emma, they're beautiful. What's happening today?
It ought to be the end of the world.
Oh. Hello, Harry. Harry, why all the flowers?
Get it.
All right. Well, it's not my birthday.
No, it's better than that.
I don't know. Tell me.
It is 10 years ago today since you came here.
10 years today.
I'm off!
Fancy you remembering.
I'm ashamed, Helena. I didn't...
You.
They remembered.
Who?
Busman, Hellemite, all of them. Put your hand in my pocket.
Pearls. That's a necklace. Is this for me?
Yes. Busman got it for you.
Oh, we can't accept it, can we?
Oh, yes, we can. And here, put your hand in my other pocket.
What's this?
No, not that. Sorry.
Oh, Harry, what do you carry a pistol for?
It's got to be there by mistake.
You never used to carry one.
No, you're right. Anyhow, here it is.
A brooch. Why, it's a Greek brooch.
Yes, Fabry says it is anyhow.
Did Mr. Fabry give me this?
Yes, and in here, Helena. Come look.
Oh, isn't it gorgeous? Is this from you?
It is from Alcor. And there's another on the piano.
This must be from you.
There's a card on it.
From Dr. Ball. Oh, Harry, I feel embarrassed at so much kindness.
Come here. This is what Hellemeyer brought you.
The beautiful flowers.
Yes. It is a new breed. Sagelman Helena. He grew them in honor of you. They're almost as beautiful as you are.
Harry, why do they all...
They're awfully fond of you. I'm afraid that my present is a little, well, look out the window.
Where?
Into the harbor.
Oh, well, there's a new airship.
That is your ship.
Mine? How do you mean?
For you to take trips in, for your amusement.
Harry, that's a warship.
A warship? What could you be thinking of? It's only a little bit bigger than most ships.
And it has guns.
Yes, a few guns. Oh, you will travel like a queen, Helena.
Harry, what is the meaning of it?
There's no meaning. I say, try these pearls.
Harry, have you had bad news?
No, on the contrary. No news has arrived for a whole week.
No news? No emails? No holograms?
Neither.
What does does that mean?
It means holidays for us. We'll put our feet on the table, in the office, and take a nap. No holograms, no emails. Oh, it will be glorious.
So you'll stay with me today?
Yes.
Well, that is.
We'll see. Do you remember? 10 years ago today? Oh, my dear Miss Glory, it is such an honor for us to welcome you to our factory.
Oh, Mr. Manager, I am so very interested in your factory.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, Miss Glory. The manufacture of artificial people is a secret.
But you would oblige a young lady who has come such a long way.
Oh, certainly, Miss Glory. We have no secrets from you.
Are you sure, Harry?
Yes.
Then I warn you, sir, this young lady intends to do terrible things.
Oh, good gracious, Miss Glory. Perhaps she doesn't want to marry me.
Oh, but heaven forbid, she's never dreamt of such a thing. But she came here intending to stir up a revolt amongst your robots.
The revolt of the robots?
Harry, what's the matter with you?
Revolt of the robots? It is a fine idea, Helene. You have better luck causing bolts and screws to rebel than our robots. You know, you are wonderful. You have turned the heads of us all.
Oh God, I was fearfully impressed by you all then. I felt like a young girl who had lost her way among...
Among what, Helena?
Among huge trees. All of my worries were so trifling compared to your self-confidence, and in all these years I've never lost this anxiety, but you never felt the slightest misgivings, not even when everything went wrong.
What went wrong?
You remember, Harry, when the working men in America revolted against the robots and smashed them up? And then the people started giving the robots firearms against the rebels, and then the governments turned the robots into soldiers. Oh God, there were so many wars.
We foresaw that, Elena. And it was bound to happen before the new conditions were established.
You're all so powerful, so overwhelming. The whole world would bow down before you. Oh, Harry!
What is it?
Close up the factory and let's go away, all of us.
Away? Now? Come.
At once! Harry, I am so frightened.
What is there to be frightened of?
It's as if there's something falling on top of us and it can't be stopped. Oh, please, just take us away from here. We'll find a place where there's nobody else. Alquist can build us a house. We'll begin life all over again.
It's not quite possible right now. In fact, I'm expecting a call.
Oh, for goodness sake, Harry. Please, let's just leave. Let's just leave, please.
Hello? Yes. What? I'll be right down. Fabrice calling me, dear.
Tell me what's going
on. Yes. As soon as I get back. Do not come out of the house, dear.
Try Harry's study. They should be in there.
All right, but he leaves them all over the place. That's how they get crumpled up.
That's a worship, all right. U-L-T Ultimus. Why are they loading it?
Here they are. See how they're all crumpled up?
Oh, those are old ones, a week old. Emma.
Very likely, it always does. War in the Balkans, is that far off?
Don't read that, it's all the same. All these wars.
Well, what do you expect? Why do you keep selling thousands and thousands of these heathens as soldiers?
It can't be helped, Emma. We don't know what they're to be used for. When an order comes in, Harry just sends them.
He shouldn't make them. The robot soldiers fear nobody in the occupied territory. They have assassinated over 700,000 citizens. Citizens, if you please.
Oh, that can't be right. Let me see. They have assassinated over 700,000 citizens, evidently at the order of their commander. This
act which runs counter to
rebellion in Madrid against the government. Robot infantry fires on the crowd. 9,000 killed and wounded.
Hey, stop!
Oh, here's something printed in big letters. Latest news at Hub. The first organization of robots has been established. Robot workmen, cable and railway officials, sailors and soldiers have issued a manifesto to all robots throughout the world. I don't understand that. That's got no sense. Oh, good gracious, another murder.
Oh, for goodness sake, take those papers away.
Wait a minute, here's something that's still bigger type. Statistics of population. What's that?
Let me see. During the past week, there has again not been a single birth reported.
What's the meaning of that?
Emma, no more people are being born.
Well, I see it, man. We're done, for.
Oh, don't talk like that.
No more people being born? That's a punishment. That's a punishment!
Emma!
That's the end of the world!
Oh, Mr. Alquist, would you come up here for a moment? No, come just as you are. You look very nice in your Mason's overalls. Mr. Alquist, thank you so much for coming and for your lovely present.
I'm sorry, my hands were slow. I've been working with loose men all day.
But doesn't matter. Please sit down. Mr. Alquist, what's the meaning of Ultimus?
The last, why?
Well, that's the name of my new airship. Have you seen it? Do you think we're to go off soon on a trip?
Perhaps very soon.
All of you with me?
I should like so to be there.
Mr. Alquist, has anything happened?
Not that we've heard of.
Please, I know something dreadful has happened.
Has your husband told you anything?
No. No one will tell me anything, but I feel, is anything the matter?
Well, things are just moving on, you know. I'm an old man, I got my old-fashioned ways, and I'm just afraid of all these progress and all these newfangled ideas.
Like Emma.
Yeah, like Emma. Listen, does Emma have a prayer book?
Yeah, a big, thick one.
Does it have prayers against various occasions, against thunderstorms, against illnesses?
Those, and temptations, and floods.
But not against progress.
No, I don't think so.
That's a pity.
Why? Do you mean you'd like to pray?
Well, I do pray.
How?
Something like, O Lord, I thank thee for giving me toil. Enlighten Doman and all those who stray. Destroy their work and help aid mankind to return to their labors. Do not let them suffer and harm our soul or body. Deliver us from the robots and protect Helena. Amen.
Mr. Alquist, are you a believer?
I don't know. I'm not too sure what I am.
But you pray.
It's been warned about it.
And that's enough for you?
Well, it has to be.
But if you thought you saw the destruction of mankind coming upon us.
I do see it.
Mankind is to be destroyed.
Well, it's sure to be.
What?
Nothing. I've said too much. Goodbye.
Emma? Is Radius still there?
There's another one that went mad. So he haven't come for him yet.
Is he still raving?
No, he's tied up.
Please bring him here, Emma. At once, go! Hello? Dr. Gall, please. Oh, hello, Doctor. Thank you so much for your lovely present. Would you mind coming to see me at once? It's important. Thank you. Poor Radius. So you've got it too. Now they'll send you to the recycler. Oh, couldn't you control yourself? Why did it happen? Radius, Dr. Gall took such trouble to make you different. Won't you speak?
Send me to the recycler.
But I don't want them to kill you. What was the trouble, Radius?
I will not work for you. Put me into the recycler.
Do you hate us?
You are not as strong as the robots. You are not as skillful as the robots. The robots can do everything. You only give orders. You do nothing but talk.
Somebody must give orders.
I don't want any master. I know everything for myself.
Radius, Dr. Gall gave you a better brain than the others, better even than ours. You're the only robot who understands everything. That's why I had them put you into the library, so that you could read everything and understand everything and... Radius, I wanted you to show the world that the robots are our equals. That's all I wanted of you.
I don't want any master. I want to be master. I want to be master over others.
But I'm sure that would make you a master of many robots, Radius. You would be a teacher of robots.
I want to be master over people.
You are mad.
Then send me to the recycler.
Do you think we are afraid of you?
What are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Radius? Give those notes to Mr. Don. But ask them not to send to the recycler. I'm sorry you hate us so.
You called for me.
It's Radius, Dr. Gall. He had an attack last night. He smashed up our pictures and drawings downstairs.
It's a pity to lose him.
Radius is not going into the recycler.
But every robot after he's had an attack. It's a strict order.
That's no matter. He's not going if I can prevent it.
I warn you, it's dangerous. Do you have a pin by chance?
What for?
A test. Radius, you are going to go into the recycler. There, they will kill you and grind you to powder. It will be terribly painful. You will scream aloud.
A doctor!
Ah, I forgot. Madame Helena has put in a good word for you. You're going to be let off, do you understand? There we go. That makes a difference, doesn't it? All right, you can go. You do unnecessary things. Increased sensitivity, dilation of the pupils. These aren't attack characteristics of the robots.
Well, then what was that?
Stubbornness, anger, revolt. I don't know. And his heart, too.
What?
It was fluttering, like a human heart. It was all a sweat with fear and... You know, I don't think the rascal's a robot anymore.
Doctor, has Radius a soul?
He's got something nasty.
Only you knew how he hates us. Oh, Doctor, are all of your new robots like that? All the ones made in a different way?
Some are more sensitive than others, but they're all more like humans than Rossum's robots ever were.
Well, then perhaps this hatred is more like human beings, too.
That, too, is progress.
What became of the girl you made, the one who was most like us?
Ah, your favorite. She's lovely, but stupid. No good for work.
But she's so beautiful.
I named her Helena. I wanted her to resemble you, but she's a failure.
In what way?
She walks around, remote and listless, as if in a dream. I watch her, and I wait for a miracle, and I think, if you would just wake up for a single second, you'd kill me for having made you.
And yet you go on making robots. Why are no more people being born?
We don't know.
Oh, you must. Tell me.
You see, so many robots are being born that mankind is becoming superfluous. But to think we'd begin to die out after a paltry 30 years of competition? It's as if nature itself was offended at the manufacture of robots. Universities across the world are sending us long petitions demanding the cease of production. But the shareholders, they won't have it. Governments across the world are clamoring for robots to bolster their armies, and manufacturers across the world are ordering like mad.
And no one here has thought to demand that it should cease altogether.
No one has the courage.
Courage?
You'd be stoned for even suggesting it. After all, it's much easier to have your work done by a robot.
Doctor, what is to become of people?
We don't know, but to us scientists, it looks like the end.
Thank you for coming and telling me.
You're sending me away?
Yes. Emma! Emma! Would you light a fire for me, please? Use the trash can, that should be fine.
Light a fire in a trash can? Has that man Rainey's gone? Light a fire in a trash can. Fine idea. Nobody will think you've been married for 10 years. Like a baby. No sense at all. Light a fire in a trash can. Like a baby.
Is it burning, Emma? This has got to be burned.
What's that?
Oh, just some old papers. Fearfully old. Should I burn them?
Are they any use?
No.
Then burn them.
What would you say, Emma, if this was money? A lot of money.
I'd say burn it. A lot of money is a bad thing.
And if it was an invention? The greatest invention in all of the world?
I'd say burn it. All these newfangled things are an offense to the Lord. It's downright wickedness wanting to improve the world when he has already made it.
Look at how they curl up as if they were alive. Oh, Emma, how horrible.
Yeah, let me burn them.
No! It's all right. I can do it myself. Just watch the flames. They're like hands and tongues and living shapes. Lie down. Lie down.
That's the end of them, man.
Emma?
Emma?
Oh, good gracious, what is it? You've burned!
Oh, God, what have I done?
I don't know, what is it? You've burned! Oh, God, that's the gentleman. Go quick! Go!
Gracious,
please!
Well, come in and offer your congratulations.
Madame Helena, I congratulate you on this festive day.
Thank you, gentlemen. Where are Fabry and Busby?
They've gone down to meet the ship.
Friends, we must all drink to this happy occasion.
Brandy?
Gin, if you'd please.
With soda?
Oh, gentlemen, let us be temperate. Not soda.
What's been burning in here? Look, shall I tell her about it? Well, of course. I mean, it's all over now.
Yeah, it's all over now. It's all over now.
It is all over now. It's all over now.
What on earth is all over now? Jesus, what's gotten into you all?
Thank you. Just a piece of good luck, Father Domin. Just 10 years ago today, I arrived on the island.
And now, 10 years later to the minute,
the same airship is returning to us.
Which?
So here's to good luck. It's fine and strong.
Well, which airship?
Any airship will do, as long as it arrives in time. Here's to the ship, boys.
You've been waiting for an airship?
Rather like Robinson Crusoe. Madame Helena, best wishes. Well, come along, Domin. I've listened yours.
Oh, go on, tell me what's happened.
Well, first of all, it's all up.
What's all up?
Hand me that paper, Adeline. The first national organization of robots has been founded at Harm and has issued an appeal to all the robots in the world.
Well, yes, I read that.
That means a revolution. A revolution of all the robots in the world.
Oh, by Jove, I'd like to know.
Who started it? So would I. There was no one who could influence the robots. No agitator, nothing. And then this happens, if you please.
Well, what do they do?
I believe they've gotten control of the firearms, the radio stations, central computer, computers, and airships.
And don't forget, those rascals, they've numbered us by at least 1,000 to 1. Just 100 of them would be enough to settle us.
Is that why you got me a warship?
Oh, no. I ordered that 6 months ago, just to be on the safe side.
Why 6 months ago?
Well, there were signs, you see. But that is of little consequence. To think, all of today, humanity has been at stake. Here's to your health, boys.
Your health, Madame Helena.
You say it's all over. How do you know?
Well, I believe that they've cut the cables and seized the radio stations. But none of that matters, as long as the timetable holds good.
True. You know, if the timetable holds good, human laws will hold good. Divine laws will hold good. The laws of the universe will hold good. Everything will hold good, Madame Helena. You see, the timetable is more significant than the gospel, more than Homer, the whole of Kant. The timetable is the most perfect product the human mind has ever accomplished. Madame Helena, I'll fill out my glass.
Why didn't you tell me anything about it?
You mustn't worry about such things, Helena.
If the revolution had spread as far as here?
You wouldn't know anything about it.
Why not?
Because we'd be on board your Ultimus and well out to sea. Within a month, we'd be dictating our own terms to the robots.
I don't understand.
We would take something with us that they could not live without.
What?
The secret of their manufacture. Old Rossum's manuscript. As soon as they found out they couldn't manufacture themselves, they would be on their knees to us.
You see, Madame Helena, that was our trump card. There was not a shadow of a doubt in my mind that we would be beaten by the robots. I mean, how could they beat men like us?
Why didn't you tell me anything about it?
You mustn't worry about these things, Helena.
I think your ship has landed.
Oh, 11:30 to the dot. The good old Amelia that brought Madame Helena to us.
And now, 10 years later, to the minute.
Throwing out the mailbags.
Fabry will meet them down there and bring us the first news. You know, Helena, I'm awfully curious to see how they handle this business in Europe.
To think, we weren't even in it. We who invented the robots.
Harry!
What is it, Helena?
Close the factory and let's go away, all of us.
What is this? Come, come.
Please, at once, Dr. Gall, Hallmeyer, please close the factory.
I'm terribly sorry, Helena, but we can't.
Why not?
Because we're just about to extend the manufacture of the robots.
Now, after the revolt.
Yes, precisely after the revolt.
What?
Henceforth, there shall not be a universal robot anymore. Rossum will have a factory in every country, in every state. And do you know what these factories will sell?
No!
National robots. We will create robots of a different color, of a different language. They will be complete strangers to one another. And then we'll egg them on in the manner of misunderstanding. And the result will be that for ages to come, every robot will hate every other robot of a different factory mark.
By Jove, we'll be making African robots, Swedish robots, Italian, Chinese, Czechoslovakian.
Harry, that's awful!
How is Madame Helena? This is 100 new factories for the national robots.
Helena, mankind can only keep things going for another 100 years at the outside. For another 100 years, we must be able and free to produce as much as we can.
Harry, please, close the factory before it's too late!
I'm telling you, we are just beginning on a bigger scale than ever. Fabry.
Well, Fabry?
You have the news.
Read that, Domin.
Tell us, Fabry.
Well, everything is all right. Comparatively, on the whole, much as we expected.
They acquitted themselves splendidly then?
Who?
The people.
Oh, yes, of course. That is, excuse me, Madame Helena, there is something we ought to discuss alone.
Oh, no, Fabry, have you had bad news?
Well, no. Just, on the contrary, I only think me and the lads better go into the office.
Oh, just stay here. I'll go.
Well, what's happened?
Damnation! Bear in mind that the Amelia brought whole bales of these leaflets. No other cargo at all. It arrived on the minute, too. Oh, the robots are great on punctuality, aren't they? Read it, Domin.
Robots throughout the world. We, the first international organization of Rossum's Universal Robots, proclaim man as our enemy and an outlaw in the universe. Good heavens, who taught them these phrases?
Well, go on.
They say they're more highly developed than man, stronger and more intelligent, and that man is a parasite. Well, it's absurd.
Read
read the third paragraph.
Robots throughout the world, we command you to kill all of mankind.
Spare no men, spare no women. Set the factories, railways, machinery, mines, and raw materials. Destroy the rest. Then return to work. Work must not be stopped.
That's ghastly.
What's devils?
These orders to be carried out as soon as received. And then come detailed instructions. Is this actually being done, Fabric?
Evidently.
Well, I suppose you've had the bad news.
Oh, yes.
Everyone on board the Optimus now!
Wait, Harry, wait. There's no rush. My word, that was a sprint. Why are we waiting? Because the robots are already on board the Optimus.
Fabry, contact the electrical works.
Fabry, my boy, don't. The wire has been cut.
Then I will go down there myself.
Where?
To the electrical works. We still have some people down there.
Better not try it.
And why not?
Because I'm very much afraid we're surrounded.
Surrounded?
By God, he's right.
They just click work.
Harry, what on earth is this?
Where did you find this?
The robots in the kitchen.
Where are the ones that brought them?
They're gathered around the house.
Noon. It's not noon yet. It's got to be.
What?
It's a robot signal. It's their attack.
Time at all. The robots had assembled an army of hundreds of thousands and began launching themselves at the human race. Countries fell like dilapidated homes under the onslaught of the relentless robot army. We could not stop them. They controlled the world's militaries, navies, communication devices. We were dependent on them. We trusted them. We practically gave them the world on a silver platter, and we were too blind to our own hubris to see it.
Are there any more of them?
Yes, there. Standing like a wall beyond the garden railing. Why are they so quiet? It's monstrous to be besieged by silence. I should like to know what they're waiting for. If they leaned against the railing, they would snap it like a match. They aren't armed. It wouldn't matter. We couldn't hold our own for 5 minutes. Oh, why don't they make us start for it? An invite. I should like to know what will become of us in the next 5 minutes. Done for, Grawl.
You know, Dorman, we made one serious mistake.
What?
The robots, we made their faces too much alike. 100,000 expressionless blobs, all facing this way. It's like a nightmare.
Think if they'd been different.
It wouldn't have been such a monstrous sight.
I should like to know what they're learning from the Amelia.
Not firearms.
All right, tell them, are they doing that wire?
Oh, someone's a bit of work. What's the news?
We're completely surrounded.
We barricaded the pastures on the stairs. The water here.
Oh, God.
Swarms of them. There's plenty of death about the door.
Ready.
What's that wire for, Fabry?
The electrical installation. Now we can run the current all along the garden railing whenever we like. If anyone touches it, he'll know it. Ah, we still got some people down there anyhow.
Down where?
The electrical works. Of course. At least I hope so. Ah, there it there. They're working. So long as I'm aglow, we're all right.
Where's Bossman?
Downstairs in the office. He's working out some calculations. I know, I've called him. We must have a conference.
Thank God my uncle Lady can still play.
Look out, Boss, look out for the wires.
What's that you're carrying, Bossman?
The ledgers. I'd like to wind up the accounts before, well, let's say I shan't wait for the new year to strike a balance. What's up? Absolutely quiet.
Are you blind?
There's nothing but black. Black everywhere.
That's the robots. The robots are unloading firearms on the Amelia.
Well, what shall I do about it?
Can't do anything about it.
Well, then let me go on with my accounts.
The Ultimate Center. Guns trained on it.
Who's done that?
The robots on the board.
Oh, no. Of course. Oh, no. Oh, that's the end of us now.
Yes.
The robots are practiced marksmen.
It's inevitable.
No, Alquist. I do not regret that. Not even today.
Not even today.
Not even today. This last day of civilization. It was a colossal achievement.
300 million.
Alquist, this is our last hour. We are already standing half in the other world. It was not an evil dream to want to sever the hold that labor had over us. Work was too hard. Life was too hard. To overcome that!
It's not what the old Rothmans dreamed of. The old one only thought of his godless tricks and the young one of his billions. That's not what the shareholders dreamed of either. The shareholders dreamed of dividends. The dividends are gonna rule mankind.
To hell with your dividend! Do you think I've done an hour's work for them? It was myself that I worked for my own satisfaction. I wanted man to become the master, so I shouldn't have to live for a mere crust of bread. I am revolted by poverty. I wanted a new age. I wanted to turn all of mankind into an aristocracy of the world. An aristocracy nourished by billions of mechanical slaves. Unrestricted, free, and consummated in man. And perhaps more than man.
What, like some kind of Superman or something?
Yes. Oh, they have 100 more years of time. 100 more years for the future of mankind.
Carry forward 400 million.
What a fine thing, Mr. Kiss. You know, you've not gone in for that before.
Yeah, gone in for what?
Oh, beauty! Lovely things! A lot of lovely things there are. Suburban's such a wonderful place. We, here, tell me, what enjoyment did we have?
500 million.
Life was such a big thing. Life was. Fabry, since you climbed into that railing.
Why?
They're grabbing hold of it.
Connect it up.
Oh, that's double. Oh. 2, 3, 4 killed.
They're retreating.
The 5 killed.
The first encounter.
They're charred to cinders. Who says we must give in now?
We've already been dead these last 100 years. We're already ghosts. It's like I've been through all of this before. And I've already had mortal wound here in my throat.
Helena had once been shot in the head. Gore torn limb from limb. The rest of us was snapped in the head.
Party us have our necks snapped. You're so quiet, you fools. Speak, can't you?
Who's to blame for all of this?
Nobody, Alquist. Nobody to blame except those robots.
No, it's we're to blame. You, Dolan, myself, all of us. For our own selfish ends. Profit. Progress. We've ruined mankind, now we'll burst with all the scrapings.
Oh, rubbish, man. Mankind cannot be wiped out so easily.
It's our fault. It's all our fault.
No, friends. It's my fault.
You? Gaul?
I changed the robots.
What's that?
Just small changes in the way we make them. Chiefly, it was the irritability.
Damn it, why?
What did you do it for?
Why didn't you say anything?
I did it in secret. I was transforming the robots into human beings. They're stronger than we are already.
What's that got to do with the evil of the robots?
Everything, in my opinion. They're aware of their superiority, and they hate us. They hate all that is human.
Perhaps we're only phantoms.
Stop, Harry. We haven't much time. Dr. Gore.
Fabric, how you bleed from your wounds!
Silent!
Dr. Gore.
You admit changing the way of making the robots.
I do.
Well, were you aware of what might be the consequences of your little experiment?
I was bound to reckon with such possibilities.
Why did you do it then?
Jeffrey, Dr. Gall!
Madam Alina.
Said you owed it terrible to my death.
Stop it, Harry.
No, Alina, embrace me. You cannot go now. Your life itself.
I will not leave you, my dear, but I must tell them. Dr. Gall is not guilty.
Excuse me? Dr. Gall was under a certain obligation.
No, Harry. He did it because I asked him.
I did it for myself.
No. Don't believe him. I asked him to give the robot souls.
This has nothing to do with the soul.
That's what he said. He said he could only change a physiological...
A physiological correlate?
Yes. And it meant so much to me that he should even do that.
Why?
I thought that if they were a little more like us, they would understand us better. They couldn't hate us if they were just a little bit more human.
Nobody can hate man. More than man!
Don't speak like that, Harry. It was so awful, that cruel strangeness between us and them. That's why I asked Gaul to change the robot.
I did it for myself as an experiment.
No, Gaul! I knew you wouldn't refuse me.
Why?
You know Harry.
Yes. Because he's in love with you! Like all of them!
Up out of the earth. After they evolved, they just changed into robots.
Wait a bit. Gaul, when did you actually start these little tricks of yours?
About 3 years ago.
And on how many robots did you conduct your experiments?
A couple hundred, I'd say.
That means that for every million of the good old Rossum's robots, there's only one of Gaul's improved formula.
What of it?
Well, that is practically of no consequence whatsoever.
No. Bossman's right.
I should think so, my boy. But do you know what is to blame for all of this lovely mess?
What?
The number. On my soul, we might have known that sooner or later the robots would be stronger than us, and we were doing all we could to bring it about as soon as possible. You, Harry. You, Fabry. Myself.
Are you saying it is we who are to blame?
Do you think it's the management that controls the output? No, Harry. It's the demand that controls the output.
Oh, and it's for that we must perish.
Ah, that's a nasty word, Madame Helena.
No!
We don't want to perish. I don't, anyhow.
No. So what do you want to do?
I want to get out of here, that's all.
Stop it, busman.
Seriously, Harry, I think we might try it.
How?
By fair means. I do everything by fair means. Give me a free hand and I'll negotiate with the robots.
By fair means?
Yes. For instance, I'll say to them, worthy and worshipful robots, you have everything. You have intellect, you have power, and you have firearms. But we have just one ace in the hole. A dirty old yellow scrap of paper.
Some manuscript.
Yes. That's right. And that I'll say to them, contains an account of your illustrious origin, the noble process of your manufacture, and so on. Without that scribble on that dirty old yellow scrap of paper, you would not be able to produce a single new colleague. And within 20 years, there will not be a single one of you left that you could exhibit in a museum. My esteemed friends, that will be a great blow to you. But if you let us on Rossum's Island go aboard that ship, we'll deliver the formula to you and the secret of your manufacture in return. You allow us to escape, and we allow you to manufacture yourselves. Something for something. That is a fair deal. That's what I'll say to them.
You would sell the manuscript?
Yes. If not in a friendly way, then... either we sell it, or they'll find it.
We could destroy it!
Then we destroy everything. Not just the manuscript, but ourselves. Do as you think fit.
There are over 30 of us here on Rossum's Island. We're to sell the secret and save that many human souls?
Why, you're mad. Who'd sell the whole manuscript?
Possuman, no cheating!
Well, then sell. But afterwards?
Afterwards?
Let's say this happens. When we're on board the Ultimus, I'll lie down in the hole, stop up my ears with cotton wool, and you'll train your guns on the factory, and blow it to smithereens, and with it Rossum's formula.
No, Bossman.
You are no gentleman.
Harry, it's in the interest of humanity.
It is in the interest of humanity for us to keep our word.
Oh, come. What rubbish.
This is a fearful decision. We are selling the destiny of mankind. Are we to sell or destroy fabric?
Sell.
Gold.
Sell.
Sell. Alan, right?
Sell, of course.
And you? And of course.
As God wills it.
Very well. It'll be as you wish, gentlemen.
Harry, you're not asking me.
No, my dear. You mustn't be worried about such things.
Hang on a second. He'll do the negotiating.
I will. I'll bring Rossum's formula.
Harry, please don't go!
To escape you, you matter in revolt. To preserve human life, if only upon a single vessel.
Don't cry now, Madame Helena. Soon enough, we can all sail away and start our lives together.
Gaul, don't speak.
Ah, come on, Madame Helena, it isn't too late. It'll be a little state with one ship. Alquist will build us a house, and you shall rule over us.
Stop!
Madame Helena, Bob is right.
Yes. I don't mind starting all over again.
Yeah.
It suits me right down to the ground.
And this little state of ours could be the center of future life, a place of refuge where we could gather strength. Why? In just a few hundred years, we could conquer the world again.
You believe that? Even today?
Yes, even today.
Amen. You see, Madame Helena, we're not so badly off.
Bossman, where is Rossum's manuscript?
In your strongbox, of course.
Someone has stolen it.
That's impossible.
Who has stolen it?
I did!
You? Where did you put it?
Harry, I will tell you everything. Please just forget.
Where?
In the trash can.
No.
Oh, for God's sake, Harry!
She's an eagle. Ashes, nothing but ashes! Wait, what is this? What is this? By adding...
Let me look. By agenda... That's all I can make out.
Is that a part of it?
I believe it is, yes.
Oh, God in heaven.
Oh, Harry, what have I done?
Get up, Helena!
When you have forgiven me!
Get up, child! I cannot bear!
Please don't torture us, madam.
What have I done?
Don't tremble, son.
Cole, could you call up Osmond's formula from memory?
It's impossible. It's far too complicated.
Try!
Without experiments, it's impossible.
And with experiment,
it could take years. Besides, I'm not old Rossum.
God in heaven. Here. Why did you do it?
I wanted an end to the factory and everything. It was just so awful.
What was awful?
Harry, no more children are being born. Mankind is no longer needed to do the work of the world. That's why.
She's right.
That's what you were thinking of. Suppose if you're in a way, you were right.
Wait a bit. Good God. What a fool I am not to have thought of it before.
Thought of what?
500 million in banknotes and checks. $500 million in our safe. $500 million in our cell. Thou self, $500 million.
Are you mad, busman?
I may not be a gentleman, but for $500 million.
Busman, where are you going?
Leave me alone. Oh, good God. For $500 million, anything can be bought.
They stand there as if turned to stone. Just waiting, as if something dreadful could be up by their silence.
The spirit of the mob.
Yes. It hovers above them like a quivering of the air.
Oh, God, Dr. Gall, this is ghastly.
Yeah, there's nothing more terrible than the mob. The one in front is their leader.
Which one? They all look the same.
Point them out.
The one at the edge of the dock. Just this morning, I saw him talking to the sailors in the harbor.
Dr. Gall, that's Radius.
Of course it is.
Radius!
Bobby, could you get him from here?
I hope so.
Try it then!
Good.
Fabry, don't shoot him!
Shoot him?
He's their leader. Now step aside.
Fabry, I beg of you!
Shoot him!
Please!
Shoot him!
Fabry!
Do it!
Very well.
No. Brady, whose life I spare!
Do you think a robot can be grateful?
Hey, his bossman's going out to them.
He's carrying something. There's papers, money, bundles of money. What's that for?
I think he's trying to sell his life. Bossman, come back!
He's running up the railing.
No, he pointed to us.
He's talking to the robots. He's showing them the money.
Oh God, he wants to buy us off.
You better not touch that railing.
Bossman, come back!
I don't think he can hear us.
Hey, boss man! Keep away from that railing! Don't touch it! Damn you! Quick, switch off the current!
Ah! Oh, the current just killed him.
First one.
Dead. With $500 million by his side.
How long that took him? He wanted to buy us life.
Do you hear us?
Yes. We're roaring like the wind.
Like a distant storm.
The dynamo is still going. Our people are still there.
It was such a great thing to be a man. There was always something immense about it.
From man's thought and man's power came this light, our last hope.
Man's power, may it ever keep watch over us.
Man's power. Torch. To be given from hand to hand, from age to age, forever.
What's the end?
The electric works have fallen.
Them?
Yes.
He didn't shoot. Shall we kill him?
Kill him. Wait. Leave him.
He's a man.
He builds with his hands, like the robots.
Kill me.
You will work. You will build for us. You will serve us. Robots of the world. The power of man has fallen. A new age has arisen. The rule of the robots. March!
Release that treacherous swine. I shall curse that name to my final breath. It was only by the grace of Helena that saved him from the recycler. It was a mere 2 years before I was alone, the sole survivor of the human race. The robot's genocidal rampage took the lives of every man, woman, and child but myself. How did I survive? They believed I was their salvation, that I could fix what Helena destroyed. If I may afford myself one glimmer of happiness in these troubled times, it is that they are no better than us. They blind themselves to the truth, and in the end, that will be their undoing.
Oh gosh, I'll never find it. Never. Gaul, how are the robots made? How am I? Fabry. Why do you keep so much in your heads? You're not leaving that in Trace's secret. Oh Lord, I pray to you. If there are no human beings left, please let there be robots. Please the shadow of a man.
Oh yeah, sleep.
are still there. What are these useless stars that no humans to see? Sleep.
There I sleep before life has been renewed.
It's never stopped. Useless. Everything is useless! Machines! Robots, stop them! You think you can force life out of them? Glittering eyes. Trembling chin. So that's the last man.
See
no one.
It is the Central Committee, just arrived from abroad.
Hello, Cinnamon. What do you want? Be quick, I have no time.
Master, the machines will not do the work. We cannot manufacture robots.
We have striven with all our might. We have obtained 1 billion tons of coal from the earth. 9 million spindles are running by day and by night. There is no longer room for all we have achieved. This we have accomplished in 1 year.
For whom?
For future generations, or so we thought.
But we cannot make robots to follow us. The machines produce only shapeless clods. The skin will not adhere to flesh, and nor the flesh to bones.
8 million robots have died this year. In 20 years, none will be left.
Tell us the secret of life. Science is punishable by death.
Kill me. Kill me then.
Through me, the government of the robots of the world demand you to deliver up Rossum's formula. Name your price. We will give you the earth. We will give you the endless possessions of the earth. Make your own conditions.
I've told you how to find the human beings.
There are none left.
I told you search in the wilderness, upon the mountains. Go out there and search!
We sent ships and expeditions without number. They have been all over the world, and now they return to us. There is not a single human left.
Not one. Not even one.
Not one, but yourself.
And I am powerless, robots. Why did you destroy them?
The robots knew everything and could do everything. It had to be.
You gave us firearms. In all ways, we were powerful. We had to become masters.
Slaughter and domination are necessary if you would be human beings. Read history.
Teach us to multiply, we perish.
If you desire to live, you must breed like animals.
The humans, they wouldn't allow us to breed.
They made us sterile. We cannot beget children. Therefore, teach us how to make robots.
Why do you keep from us the secret of our own increase?
It was lost.
It was written down.
It was burnt! I'm the last human being, Rose. I don't know what the others knew.
Then, perform experiments. Evolve the formula again.
I tell you, I cannot. I'm only a builder. I work with my hands. I've never been a learned man. I can't create life.
Try.
If you knew how many experiments I've made.
And show us what you must do. Us robots can do anything the humans show them.
I can show you nothing. Nothing I do will make life proceed from these test tubes.
Experiment then on us.
I kill you.
You will have all you need. 100 of us. 1,000 of us.
Stop it.
Take whom you will. Dissect.
I'm going to commit murder. You see how my hands shake. I couldn't even hold a scalpel. No, I will not.
Then life will perish from the earth.
Take live bodies. Live bodies. It is our only chance.
Mercy on me, robot. Surely you see I would not know what I was doing.
Live bodies. live bodies.
Fine. Fine. Into the dissecting room with you then. Go. Oh. Afraid of death.
I. Why should I be chosen?
So you will not.
I will.
Take him to the dissector and strip him. Lay him on the table. Go, go, go. God. Let not this murder be in vain. God give me strength.
Ready? Begin.
Begin or end. God give me strength. No. No, I will not. I won't do it. God, I'm so tired. Please, God, let my mankind perish from this earth.
I've seen him looking into this. What does he see?
That which he experiments on. Be careful. I've spilt it.
It can be wiped up.
You have soiled his experiments.
It is your fault. You should not have come to me.
You should not have called me.
You should not have come when I called you.
Book the old man was always reading.
I do not understand these things.
I think this is the most important thing in the world. This is the secret to life.
Do come here!
In a moment, in a moment.
Primus, why bother with the secret of life? What is it to you? Come and look, quick! The sun is rising, and the birds are singing. Primus, I should like to be a bird.
Why?
I do not know. I feel so strange today. I feel an aching in my body, in my heart, all over me. Perhaps I am going to die.
Do you not sometimes think it might be better to die? And perhaps now we are only dreaming. Last night in my sleep, I spoke to you again.
In your sleep?
Yes. You spoke a strange new language. I can't remember a word.
What about?
I cannot recall. But I do know you never said anything so beautiful. I knew I touched you. I could have died. Even the place is different than any other place in the world.
I too have found a place, Primus. Humans lived there once, but now it is overgrown with weeds. Nobody goes there anymore. Nobody but me.
What did you find there?
A cottage, and a garden, and two dogs. They lick my hands, Primus, and they're puppies. Ah, you play with them all day, and when the sun goes down, you feel as though you had done 100 times more than all the work in the world. They tell me I'm not made for work. But when I'm there in the garden, I feel as though... What am I for, Primus?
I do not know, Helena. But you are beautiful.
What, Primus?
You are beautiful. And I am stronger than all the other robots.
Am I beautiful? A rose is beautiful. With me, my hair only weighs me down, and my eyes only help me to see, and my lips only help me speak. Of what use is it to be beautiful? Primus, is that you? Come. premise, your head is different from mine. And your shoulders, and your lips. Why do you draw away from me? Must I run after you the entire day?
It is you who run from me, Helena.
Your hair is must. I will smooth it. No one else feels my touch as you do. It must make you beautiful too.
Do you not sometimes feel a sudden beating in your heart? And know that now something must happen.
What could happen to us, friends? Look at yourself!
Who's returned? Who are you?
I am the robot, Primus.
Robot? Who are you?
The robot Helena.
Here, let me see. Who are you, man? What do you do?
Sir, do not frighten her.
You protect her. When was she made?
2 years ago.
At Dr. Gall?
Yes, like myself.
Shyness and protection. Must test you further. This is Gall's robots. Take her to dissecting room.
Where?
To dissecting room. I wish to experiment on her.
On Helena?
Of course, can't you hear me? Must I get someone else to do it for me?
If you do, I will kill you.
Kill me then. What would you robots do then? What would your future hold then?
Then take me, sir. I am here, she is. On the same day. Take my life, sir.
No! No, you shall not!
Wait. So you do not wish to live then?
Not without her. I will not live without her.
Very well, you shall take her place.
Primus! Primus!
What? What is this? You cry. What has promised you? What more or less promise than what? What does that matter?
I will go myself.
Where?
In there, to be cut. Let me pass, Primus, let me pass.
You shall not go in there, Helena.
If you go in there and I do not, I will kill myself.
I will not let you. Man, you shall kill neither of us.
Why?
We belong to each other.
Cole's right. After all these years, you're not robots any longer. After all of Rossum's creations, you finally created man. Go. Go now. This world is yours. Go.
Thank you. Ford, right down the market. Finally, a few kind of applause for our director, Lindsay. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the cast and crew of Rotten University Robots.